Welcome back to Bulldog Builds. Today, the students will be removing the steering components from the Cadillac to prepare it to become a rear-wheel drivetrain. Then we'll check in with the tractor team where they're going to be installing the final two engine sleeves. We hope you enjoy this episode.
After determining the size plate we wanted to use, we cleaned it, cut it, and drilled mounting holes for the center link. We then marked the center link for drilling, then drilled it. Then we used a hammer to mark a template for where there were already holes in the frame, so we could avoid them when drilling to mount the plate. This is a trick commonly used when making gaskets. The plate was loosely mounted to the drag link. Using our template, we marked and drilled the plate to mount to the frame.
So when completed, this is how the steering will be locked to the crossmember. Our tractor block needed to be sleeved. What the sleeving process is overboring the engine cylinder so that it will accept a cylinder sleeve. Then the cylinder sleeve is pressed into place, and then we will machine the inside of the sleeve surface so that we can get it back to factory specification. In doing this operation, we would leave a step at the bottom of the cylinder so it gives a place for the sleeve to rest on. And then after that, we will machine the entire surface together with the block and the sleeve. Now that will leave a little ring between the step and the cylinder sleeve, which in most cases wouldn't cause a problem. As with most automotive pistons, we have three ring grooves. We have two compression rings and an oil control ring assembly, and all of these are above the piston pin. So if we were going to sleeve an engine, that groove at the bottom wouldn't really factor in or cause any problems with our cylinder or with our piston, either one. With our tractor, we've got something a little bit unique. We have both of our compression rings at the top and above the piston pin as normal, but the oil control ring assembly is well below that. So in the travel, that oil control ring assembly would actually have crossed where the groove is between the cylinder and the bottom step. So what we did is we got a little creative. We actually took the external portion of the cylinder sleeve and we stepped it slightly so that when it went into the cylinder, the step would still make contact, so it had a place to rest. But the remainder of the sleeve protruded down far and below that. So no matter how far the piston went down into the bottom of its travel, the rings would never have gone over that groove. Now, it may not have made too much of a difference anyway, but what our concern was is that the rings crossing that groove every time it went up and down on the cylinder, we were concerned about a little bit of wear for the ring, but what would have been worse is if it actually would have caught and broke the ring. So this was actually the perfect solution. It was a lot more work, but it was the perfect solution for what we were trying to achieve with this engine block.
Here you can see the step that we machined at the bottom of the cylinder and the reason we needed the sleeve, that hole at about 12 o'clock.
The sleeves were left in a cooler overnight in dry ice. Then sleeve retainer was put on to aid in the installation to help keep the cylinder locked in place.
Here you can see the sleeve protruding from the bottom of the block, as well as the top. This will be machined flush later. Next time on Bulldog Builds. Students continue taking components from the Cadillac chassis. Machining operations will begin on the cylinder sleeves. We will have a SEMA update, and we'll see what the daytime classes are up to. See you then.